Over 3 weeks have passed and the standoff in Sabah shows no signs of easing. But how do we open the lines of diplomacy amid the tension? Misunderstandings are an inevitable part of our relationships with our families, friends, or co-workers. While many of us shy away from confrontation, some may think tackling the problem head-on is the way to go. Whatever your conflict resolution style is, we know pointing fingers or raising voices never help. So today we ask you, what is the most effective way to diffuse conflict and tension?
All of us are silent.
I know.
The best way.
It's such a complicated issue, though. I mean, in relation to this,
let's not relate it to that.
Okay.
Let's talk about easing, normal things.
Easing conflict in relationships.
Well, number one, of course, you try to avoid it, right? But if you can't avoid it,
try to avoid the confrontation.
Sometimes it's actually good to confront it. Mm-hmm. It's the manner by which you confront it.
Right.
For example, with your friend or your partner, which is the best way to actually handle a problem or an irritation that is ongoing. Mm-hmm. Diba? Like you and I can handle it differently, but with your partner, you should probably handle it another way because we're all different people.
Right.
And we all take it in different ways, right? So I guess it's really, for me, it's to each his own. You study the person you're
right.
you know,
dealing with.
You're dealing with and you deal with it in different versions, I think.
Yeah, it depends on who it is and how they will receive it. Do you guys have any suggestions?
None, all right, so. Well, that's how we handle this.
I don't really appreciate the way that you just. No, but people always say communication is key, whether it's with your work relationships or your personal relationships. Of course, sometimes we all fail to communicate effectively, but you know, they teach you in college, they teach you in like business courses, effective communication is the way to go, but it becomes so intricate sometimes. So I think
especially when emotions are already involved.
Right. I tend to be the one that's like, let's talk it out, let's flush it out until we're both so tired that you just, you know, put your hands up in the air.
That.
And some people are just like, don't push me up against a wall or else.
Right. Well, I think that's what Mickey was saying. I mean, some things work for some people, some things don't work for other people. Things usually work out best for me with copious amounts of chilled libations. that always helps, letting the truth out.
Mm-hmm.
I think, you know, it also kind of helps, which I've tried before, is maybe writing it down and then saying, you might not want to hear my side of the story right now, but when you are
face to face is not as good as maybe sort of easing into it, maybe a little bit of a
and when you
message.
Write a letter, you do not have that fear of that person butting in,
right.
You actually want to say something, you know, so you lose your train of thought writing it. You won't lose your train of thought doing that. So that's another way.
Sundo mo na lahat, ilabas yung galit mo. Hindi mo makakasagot ka.
Eh kung hindi basahin.
Gives the person time to digest it, see?
And also it spares the emotions. You can be a little more clear about what the issues are, rather than bringing up all kinds of things that may not be related.
All right. Well, let's see if our viewers have other suggestions. Join our discussion by posting your answers to our question of the day. What is the most effective way to diffuse conflict and tension? Tweet ANC Alerts and ANC Mornings. Please use the hashtag ANC Asks or post your reply on our Facebook page, ANC 24/7. You can also text REACT space ANC space name, age, address, reaction to 2331 for Globe, TM and Sun and 231 for Smart and TNT. We also say put it in a song, right?